died at approximately 1 o'clock Central Standard Time today here in Dallas. He died of a gunshot wound in the brain.
And will, to the best of my ability,
preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
So help me God.
If a free society cannot help the many who are poor, it cannot save the few who are rich. And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
You tend to see John Kennedy as youthful, glamorous, and vaguely progressive. But the day he died, we lost an invaluable treasure. We lost a man of peace who tried to get the American people to see our Cold War enemies not as despicable, inhuman monsters, but as people like us.
No government or social system is so evil that its people must be considered as lacking in virtue. But we can still hail the Russian people for their many achievements in science and space, in economic and industrial growth, in culture, in acts of courage. Our most basic common link is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's futures, and we are all mortal.
And, though you're probably not aware, you lost the man who saved your life on October 17, 1962. U.S. spy planes had photographed Russian missiles in Cuba capable of hitting Washington and the entire East Coast. Kennedy announced a blockade of Cuba.
This government, as promised, has maintained the closest surveillance of the Soviet military buildup on the island of Cuba. Within the past week, unmistakable evidence has established the fact that a series of offensive missile sites is now in preparation on that imprisoned island.
And Kennedy's generals and advisors were telling him that he and they should slip away to the safety of bomb shelters, attack the missile sites, and then launch a full-scale invasion of Cuba. They assured Kennedy that the Russian missiles were not ready, but that they should all go to bomb shelters anyway, just to be safe, and leave the rest of us out to die. Kennedy thought about it, and then he told them that nobody was going anywhere, that if anyone died, they would be the first to go, sitting as they were in the White House, the prime target of those Russian missiles. And Kennedy suggested that, with this new perspective, they should all work out another, safer plan. It turns out that the generals were wrong. The Russian missiles were not only ready, they were armed with nuclear warheads, which the local commanders were authorized to use if attacked. Kennedy saved the world and you from nuclear holocaust that day, a holocaust that almost certainly would have killed everyone in the Northern Hemisphere. Eisenhower warned us that the greatest threat to American security came from
the military-industrial complex.
And Kennedy heard him. And then he called on the world to strengthen the United Nations organization, to help them not just to rein in the military-industrial complex, but to eliminate it completely. Before he died, Kennedy told the United Nations,
"For in the development of this organization rests the only true alternative to war. And war appeals no longer as a rational alternative. For a nuclear disaster spread by wind and water and fear could well engulf the great and the small, the rich and the poor, the committed and the uncommitted alike. Mankind must put an end to war, or war will put an end to mankind. It is therefore our intention
to challenge the Soviet Union, not to an arms race, but to a peace race, to advance together, step by step, stage by stage, until general and complete disarmament has been achieved. Under the eyes of an international disarmament organization, a steady reduction in force, both nuclear and conventional, until it has abolished all armies and all weapons, except those needed for internal order and a new United Nations peace force. And it starts that process now, today, even as the talks begin. Never have the nations of the world had so much to lose or so much to gain. Together we shall save our planet, or together we shall perish in its flames.
What a terrible crime and what a terrible loss to lose this man. And, as we should be, the world is still haunted by our failure to act.
Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. Oh, have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them are gonna stop at the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Yes, some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption.